Hi everybody, this is Miss Barnacle again, and today we're going to start our intro to fractions. When you're talking about fractions, a lot of what you need to know is the vocabulary, and you will see here that it talks about the word fraction means to break, so to where you take a big piece and you break it into smaller pieces. There are things when you divide it into equal parts. Here is an example of that when you're talking about measuring food, measuring liquids, when you're measuring using a ruler. Okay, when you talk about that, you're talking about taking one big thing and breaking it into smaller parts. And when you have a fraction, there are two things that you need to know. Number one, the top number is called the numerator, and the bottom number is called the denominator. The bar that separates them is called the fraction bar, and you need to know that the denominator cannot be equal to zero. It must always be a number that is bigger than zero. These examples show you, it says what fraction is shaded, and all of these notes are going to be worked out for you on the website so that you can download them and get all of the examples worked out. But in example A, you will notice there are three pieces that are shaded yellow out of eight. So the fraction would be three fraction bar eighths, 3/8. In part B, that would be one out of six. So that'd be 1/6. And the last part would be 7/10. Now, there are two different types of fractions. You have a proper fraction where the top number is smaller than the bottom number, and then you have an improper fraction where the top number is bigger than the bottom number. And the examples that I'm going to work out for you on the board are on this chart where it asks you to identify the numerator, the denominator, and then tell me if it's proper or improper. So on the board, we see our first fraction. It says the fraction 1/3. And so to identify the numerator is the number on top of the fraction bar. So that would be the digit 1. Okay. In the second fraction, the numerator would be the digit 3 that's on top. And in the bottom fraction, the 3 is also the numerator. Okay. Then we come to the denominator, which would be the bottom. So the bottom on this first fraction would be a 3. On the second fraction, it's a 3. And on the bottom fraction, it's a 1. Okay? Now, to determine whether it's proper or improper, you look at the numerator. If the numerator is smaller than the denominator, then it is a proper fraction. So we would write proper. When I look at the second fraction, you will notice that the numerator and the denominator are equal to each other. And when you have that case, it is not in lowest terms. So 3 fraction bar 3 is improper because it is equal to or greater than the denominator. Okay, and the bottom fraction. The numerator is 3, the denominator is 1. Well, 3 is obviously bigger than 1, so that is also improper. Okay. That is our introduction to fractions, and our next one coming up will be intro to mixed numbers.